Hello students, welcome to our third video in our close reading series. Today we're going to be learning about making inferences from the text and coming up with some type of interpretation. So remember that inferences is dealing with reading between the lines. This is using clues from the text to draw a conclusion or an interpretation. This is a harder skill. This is where a lot of students get tripped up. They think that they're not creative enough, but it's not just about being creative and coming up with an interpretation. It's about reading what's actually embedded into the text and understanding what's happening and coming up with a conclusion based on that evidence. It's deducing what is happening. You are not going to see it directly stated in the text, but instead you're taking out an implied meaning and you're coming up with some different type of answer for what's going on. And so we're going to talk about that. First thing that I want you guys to do is to take a look at this picture, and you're going to pause the video when I say. Your goal here is to type out or write down everything that you observe in this image, all of the factual info. We're not going into any interpretations. We are just doing what we observe. So things like, what do you see? What is happening? Where is this? Who is in the picture? Etc. It's all of the explicit info that we learned from the last video you're now applying to this picture. So just pause the video now and observe. So hopefully you got a few observations or more here. There's clearly about 5 or 6 people in this image. It looks like it's in some type of movie theater or theater in general. The man here seems to be a worker there. He's coming to scold or chastise the woman for being on her phone. It also seems like this is likely to be in the early to late 2000s, like 2000, maybe 5 or 6, because there is a flip phone involved. It's not a smartphone. We don't know if this woman is with the other kids in the group behind them, but there is a man in the back who seems to be aware of what's going on and is pointing at the situation to the woman in the green, and they're both looking. He also seems like he could be happy. The girl herself doesn't seem to be upset, seems to be just locking dead eyes with this man, this worker. And so if we're now to move those observations and take what we know for sure and move it to the inferential info, we need to be aware that it's based on what we know in clues that are given to us in the picture, but also our own prior knowledge and our personal experiences and everything like that. So some questions to consider: how do the people feel in this image, and how do you know? So I want you to pause the video again and answer that question. Notice too that when I was giving you my observations, I actually gave you an inference as well, and I slipped it in there. Remember, I said that this is likely to be in about 2005 to 2008 because of the flip phone. But does it actually say that anywhere in this image? No. So I'm actually inferring it, because can people still have a flip phone today? Yes. Is it likely? Probably not. But based on my prior knowledge of knowing what the flip phone season was and what years they were out and what kind of phones people use today, I know that it is likely this picture is a little bit older. Now, in terms of inferring how the people feel, I think the worker is annoyed and fed up, but also recognizes that he doesn't really have much power here. He's looking at her to give the phone away or to make sure that she puts the phone away, and he's just annoyed, right? And he's trying to give that, come on, you know what you did is wrong. Meanwhile, I feel like this girl does not care. She's just gonna do what she wants, and the people in the back don't seem like they care that much either. The woman in the green can't really see her face too much, but she definitely doesn't look angry. She has a neutral expression, whereas the man seems like he's laughing and enjoying this spectacle. So I'm also inferring that this isn't during the movie. And I can infer that because the picture is still kind of bright, so maybe it's during the previews, maybe the lights are still on. She took the phone call and didn't leave, so she's not really missing the movie, and the people in the back don't seem that concerned with missing anything. So notice, those are inferences. How do I know that? I'm using the textual evidence here in this picture to come up with something that's plausible, right? So notice the difference between inferential information and explicit information. The explicit was just our observations of what is actually being told to us through this picture, what we actually see. The inference is more based on feelings and emotions and interpretations. So now I want you guys to take a look at this video, and we're gonna do the same thing.
My body is finely tuned like a microchip, and the flu is like a grain of sand. It could literally shut down the entire system.
So after watching that clip from Parks and Rec, what did you observe? What was actually going on? Secondly, after coming up with our observations, what do you infer? What's some of the personal experiences and prior knowledge and emotions and feelings that you can bring into this clip? Most likely, some of you brought prior knowledge of the show. Maybe you knew exactly what was going on because of your information based on you watching the show before. So you can make some intelligent inferences on that. You might also infer, even if you've never seen the show before, that maybe this has something to do with the coronavirus because of the mask, right? So notice how our own personal experiences are changing the way that we might interpret something. If I gave this to you a few months ago, many of you wouldn't even make the connection of he's wearing a mask for coronavirus. And in fact, he's actually not, because based on my prior knowledge, I know that this show was created years before this all happened. So he's really only concerned about getting sick. Right? And so look at some of the inferences that you made. I want to go back to the passage that we looked at for George Orwell's 1984 and take out not explicit information anymore, but instead make some inferences. And look what I highlighted. I highlighted bright cold day in April, striking 13, escape, and victory mansions. Now, the reason why I'm highlighting those things is because I could actually make inferences based off of that. Now, the fact that it's a bright, cold day in April. That, to me, I'm making an inference based on my prior knowledge of other books that that is a juxtaposition. April is seen as a month of new life, of new birth. It's springtime. It's the season that we're currently in. It's supposed to be nice out, but yet it's cold. Yes, it's a bright day, and it's very nice out, but it's cold outside, so not many people are probably out. That's an inference there. The text is not telling me that, but I'm inferring it. Now, secondly, the whole idea of it striking 13. That's a violent image there with the word like striking, but also 13. Why would a clock strike 13? Well, I'm going to be inferring that this specific society in this story is not our own because it's not based on a 12-hour clock. Perhaps I can infer that it's based on a 24-hour military clock. Maybe this is a very violent society that has a lot of war in its past, or maybe is currently in war and everybody is in the military. And that would also match up with the idea of them going to a Victory Mansion building, or building called Victory Mansions. So that, to me, is a bunch of inferences that I can make within a couple of sentences. Or what about this nonfiction news article that I shared with you guys from NewJersey.com? So if I pull open that article written by Matt Arco from NewJersey.com that I shared with you, I already went through all the explicit information in the previous video, but here I want to make some inferences. And real quick, I want to say this article, if you remember, said absolutely nothing about schools. It only talked about potentially having to do social distancing for another 6 to 8 weeks, and that a realistic timeline is what Murphy said is like June or July, not May. So my big inference here when I first read this was actually that schools are likely in New Jersey to be closed for the entire year. And how would I know that based on this article? Well, Murphy doesn't say it, but the inference here is that because he doesn't believe that social distancing can stop till June or July, and because I know schools end in about early to mid-June, it is likely that schools will be closed for the entire year. Again, does the article say that 100%? No, it doesn't say it at all. But I'm inferring it based on the clues given to me in this passage. And that's what inferencing is about. That's what inferential questioning is about. It's a harder skill because I'm reading what's in the article when it's not really in the article. So if I wanted to put all that into a little statement, I could say that this article implies that schools will most likely not meet again for the 2019-2020 school year, since schools end in June and Governor Murphy stated that June or July is a more realistic timeline for opening up the economy. It's short, it's sweet, it's to the point, and incorporates a relevant quotation from the actual article, and it is a big inference that I am making because he did not say that in the article, but I'm reading between the lines. Some inferential questions that might help you as you try this out for yourself are things like asking, why did the character or characters do this or do that? Or why didn't they do something? How do the characters feel in a particular moment? And how do you know? Predict what will happen in the story. Predict what will happen if something different were to show up in the story. Or even, what lesson does this text teach? What lesson does this novel or this poem show us? What's the author trying to get at? All of those are going to require inferential questioning and inferential ideas, because it's not going to be something that's standing out, flashing its lights at you in the text itself. It's not going to be the explicit information. It's going to be an inference instead.